Good morning. Welcome to worship here at Union UCC in NEFS, and welcome to those of you online joining us now or some other time during the week. Let us know you're here by liking or commenting or sharing a prayer request. Pastor Carey is preaching today. Pastor Kaylee is still on sabbatical through June 9th. We want to thank Blake and Craig and Mitchell for their music today. Thanks so much. And there is coffee hour today in Memorial Hall. You're welcome to stop by and grab a snack and share time together. Welcome to Union UCC. Welcome to worship. Join me in the call to worship. We gather in the presence of the one who abandons no one. Come, Holy Spirit, our advocate and comforter. All are welcome in this sacred place made holy through your presence with us. Open our hearts and minds this day. Guide us into a loving relationship with all your children. We gather as God's beloved people, leaving no one outside. Spark us with a word of life and radical belonging, a message that we share with others as we seek to live out Christ's love. We call on the name of God, who creates, redeems, and sustains us. Amen. Let us pray. Holy One, be with us in this sacred space. Stir your spirit in and among us as we offer our prayers and praises. We long to hear more than the groaning of creation around us, more than our own fearful groaning, from the places deep within us that we mistakenly believe are hidden from you. May your spirit intercede for us. Draw us into your presence. May we recognize you in ourselves and in our neighbors. Let us see you through all brokenness that we may find wholeness in being your body here and now. In the name of the one who fills the world with hope. Amen.
For the beauty.
Please stand. Here at Union, we say, and we mean it when we say that you are welcome here, no matter who you are on, no matter who you are or where you are in life's journey, you are welcome here. And so I invite you to share God's extravagant welcome with each other. Please be seated, and kids, come on forward. We're going to all work on learning the new Children's Time song for the summer. So the words, can you put the words up? So Isaac, you're going to kind of get a solo until your friends come up. So the words are, the fruit of the Spirit's not a coconut. The fruit of the Spirit's not a coconut. Okay. The fruit of the Spirit's not a coconut. All right. And if you want to be a coconut, you might as well hear it. You can't be a fruit of the Spirit. Don't change a slide yet. Yep, there we go. Okay. So, congregation, can you help us sing it, right? The fruit of the Spirit's not a coconut. The fruit of the Spirit's not a coconut. If you want to be a coconut, you might as well hear it. You can't be a fruit of the Spirit. Good. So with Miss Tiffany this summer, you're going to learn the fruits of the Spirit. So are we. All right, now you can switch it. Here's the hard part. Because the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience. Okay, so say all of those first. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness. Kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Okay, I'm kind of teaching it to you in the phrasing of the song, so that'll help, right? So let's do it again. Love, joy, peace, patience.
Love, joy, peace, patience.
Kindness, goodness, faithfulness.
Gentleness,
and self-control. All right, let's sing it. Because the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. You get another chance. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. One more time, just the chorus, a little bit faster, Blake. You got it. Because the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. You did great. Woo! See you guys later.
The first reading today is Book of Acts, chapter 2, verses 1 to 21. When the day of Pentecost had come, they were all together in one place. And suddenly from the heaven there came a sound like a rush of a violent wind, and it filled the entire house where they were sitting. Divided tongues as of fire appeared among them, and a tongue rested on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other languages as the Spirit gave them the ability. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven living in Jerusalem. And at the sound, the crowd gathered and was bewildered, because each of them heard one speaking to them in the native language of each. Amazed and astonished, they ask, Are not all these who are speaking Galileans? And how is it that we hear, each of us, in our own native language, Parthians, Medes, Elamites, and residents of Mesopotamia, Judea and Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt and parts of Libya belonging to Cyrene, and visitors from Rome, both Jews and proselytes, Cretans and Arabs, in our own language we hear them speaking about God's deeds of power. All were amazed and perplexed, saying to one another, "What does this mean?" But others sneered and said, "They are filled with new wine." Peter, standing with the 11, raised his voice and addressed them, "Men of Judea and all who live in Jerusalem, let this be known to you and listen to what I say. Indeed, these are not drunk, as you suppose, for it is only 9 o'clock in the morning. No, this is what was spoken through the prophet Joel. In the last days it will be, God declares, that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. Even upon my slaves, both men and women, in all those days I will pour out my spirit, and they shall prophesy. And I will show portents in the heavens above, and signs on the earth below, blood and fire and smoky mist. The sun shall be turned to darkness, and the moon to blood, before the coming of the Lord's great and glorious day. Then everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved." The second reading is from the Gospel of John, chapter 13, verses 31 through 35. When he had gone out, Jesus said, "Now the Son of Man has been glorified, and God has been glorified in him. If God has been glorified in him, God will also glorify him in himself, and will glorify him at once. Little children, I'm with you only a little longer. You will look for me, and as I have said to the Jews, now I say to you, where I am going, you cannot come. I will give you a new commandment, that you love one another. Just as I have loved you, you should also love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another." This is the end of the readings today. Our response we are singing is also a prayer. May God's word be a lamp for our feet and a light for our path.
Thank you.
is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. When I feel afraid and I think I've lost my way, still you're there right beside me. Nothing will I fear as long as you are near. Please be near me to the end. Thy word is a lamp unto
Good morning. May my thoughts and words align with the Holy Spirit's message and God's unconditional love for us today. Amen. May is Mental Health Awareness Month. Since I am coordinating some of our church community's well-being supports, we designated today and my message as the time for our mental health awareness moment. I'm going to share a personal story, which I rarely do. In fact, most people don't even know this about this part of my life. But writing this sermon and being involved in all of our church's development around mental health awareness and support has inspired me to share. My grandmother, Edith, was not a presence in my life. She was my maternal grandmother, and my earliest memories were of her appearing at our house on random holidays and my family picking her up at her apartment on Church Street in Allentown that she shared with roommates, and curiously, I did not think this was odd. Up to the second or third floor for the occasional family dinner at Walps, which the adults in my family always seemed to dread. Thinking back, she reminded me a bit of Joan Crawford in her later years with the dyed black hair and the misaligned red lipstick. But most of what I remember are the phone calls. Back in the day, you couldn't tell who was calling. You just had to take your chances and answer. I remember my mom sometimes telling me to tell her she wasn't available when she would call. Sometimes my grandmother would be crying, and on more than one occasion, my mom had to talk her off the ledge. I don't think it was the actual ledge, but she talked about men chasing her and trying to capture her. The story gets even more tragic. I discovered that my grandmother spent most of her mothering years at Allentown State Hospital, where she was committed for what now appears to be schizophrenia and bipolar disorder. She received many electric shock therapies in an attempt to cure her, and they are not the precision therapies that they have today. Unbeknownst to my mom, my grandmother's brothers and sisters were told that she died in the 1950s. She was an embarrassment to the family, and they wanted her erased. Imagine their surprise and contempt when my mom and her sister posted her obituary when she actually died on New Year's Day in 1985. Her autopsy revealed a genetic heart condition that caused reduced blood flow. Translated, that meant her mental illness was invariably a result of lack of oxygen to her brain, or at least it certainly didn't help. I think things have changed nowadays. I hope they have. I'm going to be sharing what the UCC Mental Health Network offers for support and commentary. Last Sunday was Pentecost, and we read the scripture from Acts today, I like to imagine that the Holy Spirit had some grand plan. Hey, wouldn't it be fantastic if everyone spoke in their own language so everyone could be understood? Wouldn't that be unifying? Think of the joy and camaraderie. Leave it to the humans to blow off a truly spectacular spirit-filled moment as drunkenness. The sights and sounds, the flames dancing, the multiple voices and languages being spoken by those who ordinarily would not be speaking these languages was surely overwhelming. It's a deeply unsettling story. Winds blowing open doors and flames dancing above heads, not to mention a babble of languages tumbling from familiar mouths. We like the coming of the Holy Spirit part, but what of those disciples who appeared drunk to some of the onlookers? What of the weird and seemingly unholy happenings? We tend to dismiss them and focus on the good parts, the parts like all who call on the name of the Lord will be saved. That sounds way better than holy heads on fire and uncontrollable winds and foreign languages tumbling out of familiar mouths. You know I love a good teachable moment. So here's one about Pentecost. According to this scripture, it says the people were gathered from all around the region for Pentecost. We just celebrated Pentecost last week, and you may wonder why these Jewish folks were gathered to celebrate a Christian holiday that hadn't been created yet. That's because this Pentecost, which means 50th day, was the Jewish feast of Pentecost, Shavuot, and was primarily a thanksgiving for the first fruits of harvest, and later associated with a remembrance of the law given by God to Moses on Mount Sinai. Now it is a major festival in the Christian church, celebrated on the Sunday that falls on the 50th day after Easter. It commemorates the descent of the Holy Spirit on the apostles and other disciples following the crucifixion, resurrection, and ascension of Jesus Christ, and it marks the beginning of the Christian church's mission to the world. Pentecost transformed from a Jewish feast into a Christian festival. Imagine that spectacle occurring today, right now, right here during worship. Maybe not the flames, because I'm sure Neff's station would spot them in a minute and be here, but what about the speaking in tongues? What would we attribute it to? Mass hysteria? Addiction? Hallucinations? Mental illness? But I can bet probably not the Holy Spirit or divine intervention. When we witness things unfamiliar to us, it's easy to ignore, walk away, or even condemn. But I encourage us all to listen to the scripture of John again and remind us what Jesus said. I give you a new commandment, that you love one another, just as I have loved you. By this everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another. Jesus is speaking of unconditional love, and yet there is work to love. Breaking down stigma related to mental health is not simple. It requires a great deal of love that is built out of working to understand another's journey. As we talk about breaking down stigma, we remind ourselves of what Jesus said to the disciples. Mental illness remains one of the most stigmatized disorders in North American society. Stigma refers to those negative attitudes and beliefs that arouse fear, rejection, avoidance, and discrimination against individuals with mental illness. Consequently, those individuals may internalize those negative attitudes and beliefs so much that they may conceal symptoms and fail to seek treatment, or their families fake a death to hide their shame. So what do we do about this, you may ask yourself, as we begin this year's church mission in the world? I encourage us all to educate ourselves, ask questions, talk about what is confusing, ask for help in understanding and demystifying depression, anxiety, addiction, and even the seemingly more overwhelming illnesses like schizophrenia and bipolar disorder. Questions to keep in mind: how can I help? What does someone need? How can I get involved? What do I need to learn more about? I don't mean to imply this is easy or there's a simple fix, but watch for community events here and in the area that teach, enlighten, and support those who are struggling. There is a bulletin insert today with some ideas. Sharing Life Community will hold an event in the Grove on June 6th called Sharing Hope, in which I will co-lead. Sharing Life was created to offer community opportunities to individuals who have been discharged from Allentown State Hospital due to its closure. It will be a time to connect, meditate, exercise, laugh, and be seen and heard. Our leadership planning team is committed to finding ways that we can use our church, its people, and resources to offer more opportunities to learn and grow, find care and support for our and the community's well-being. And the Penn Northeast Conference is holding an exploration of mental health awareness and spirituality with practical resources for churches and communities on October 5th here. So watch for details. The sacred stories of our faith traditions offer us hope and encouragement for everyday life. When it comes to mental health and well-being, we invite you to celebrate the power of faith to positively influence the mental health of our communities. New brain science confirms what our ancestors knew. God's love has healing power. For emotional, social, and mental well-being, faith assures of two protective factors. You are not alone, and you are loved. In today's world, this is a message that faith communities, us, are uniquely positioned to share. Spirituality is an essential part of a holistic approach to mental health and wellness. As the writer of Revelation says, God is the Alpha and Omega. God is with us in the beginning and in the end, no matter who we are or where we are on life's journey or what our mental health diagnosis is. God shows us all compassion and unconditional love, wiping away every tear from our eyes. Coming together to break the silence in worship services, we help end the stigma and shame of mental health challenges. Please support the efforts in our beloved community where we can share honestly about our mental health and where we can share God's love with one another. For those who are challenged with imbalances, know that you are seen and heard. We are trying to understand your journey. Ask for help. Trust that God is with you no matter how it seems. Know that there are people willing to help and love you and professionals who can assist. But most importantly for us all, keep foremost in your hearts and minds the words of Jesus, "Love one another just as I have loved you. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples if you have love for one another." Amen. Let us pray. Creator God, each day we live on the edge of above and below, inside and out. We live in spaces in between knowing and never knowing, between believing and questioning, between clarity and uncertainty. These spaces create confusion in us. Back and forth, we meander along a winding road that begins to feel like a labyrinth with no center, no exit, no way out. Too often we live in stuck places like these. We rock back and forth, craving something that feels certain. It feels as if there is no space for us to rest except within the wideness of your love. In you, our loneliness in the shadow fades. Instead, overwhelming shadows are replaced with the tiniest ray of hope. Hope found in a speck of light barely shining through. It reminds us when we fall, you will sit with us there. When we finally feel able to emerge from the shadows, you will be with us. Then slowly your spirit moves within us. In all times, you will be with us. For this, God of light, we are grateful. Thank you for the questions, the uncertainty, and for our confusion. Through them, we travel closer to you. Thank you for helping us listen to our inner knowing of spirit and for answers when they come. Through them, we are reminded of your constant presence. And now, bless all those who suffer today in mind, body, and spirit, whom we name in our hearts. May you bless us with all your healing ministry of love, and may we continue to be your heart and hands in this world. Amen. Let us share now the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
This weekend is a time where we remember all who serve or have served, but we especially remember those who have died in their military service, and the names of folks that we have collected, members and family members, are listed in your bulletin. And of course, we also remember all the unknown soldiers who gave their lives in service. So pray with me. God, we come with taps in our hearts, remembering those who have died for others. Soldiers, sailors, Air Corps in this country and others. Remembering those who risked their lives for others, Coast Guard, firefighter, law enforcement, both near and far away. Remembering those who go forth in emergency response, disaster relief, and aid to victims of war. Remembering those who witness for justice in the face of opposition. And remembering our own losses, some fresh wounds, some long familiar sadnesses. Day is come, not just one, but a year full of dawns in the east. While some rust, we are blessed, given peace. Amen. We remember that Memorial Day began when Confederate war widows decorated the far from home graves of Union soldiers. We remember and pray for those who grieve on all sides of a conflict. We remember that Memorial Day also began at Charleston's Washington Racecourse, where newly freed slaves honored prisoners of war. We remember and pray for people everywhere who are seeking freedom or living with the loss of freedom. We remember that May 30th was chosen for Memorial Day because it was one day that did not commemorate a particular battle. We remember and pray for a time when every day is an anniversary of peace. We remember Anzac Day, where Australians and New Zealanders memorialized not only those in combat, but nurses, stretch bearers, conscientious objectors, and those who bear home front burdens. We remember and pray to be aware of the gifts of many in our common causes. We remember Christmas Eve truces and paper cranes, amnesties and poppies, folded flags, and the desperate need of veterans for gratitude made real and support. We remember and pray for memorializing, not confined to a holiday, but alive in the spirits of young and old, enlisted and civilian, brand new Americans, and those with deep hometown roots, people of every faith, no faith, people willing to leave their politics outside the door in order to embrace everyone. God be with us as we remember. Amen. As we move into our summer mode here, some of our activities are winding down. There's still plenty of ways to participate in worship on Sundays. Next Sunday, June 2nd, we'll have communion at both 8 and 10:30, but it is also the last 8 o'clock service for the summer until September. And so, and then your bulletin also lists the outdoor services in the Grove at 10:30. The first one is June 30th. It's also the day of our Build Your Own Sunday. So be prepared for your, if not your first church summer hot dog, at least hot dogs and ice cream. Next Saturday, I cannot believe it's June already, but June 1st is our church and countrywide yard sale. We hope you all come out. If you're not already signed up to volunteer or help or bake, please come out and shop and eat and support the effort and just make it a great day for everyone. June 16th, we're recognizing graduates. So if you or someone in your family is a graduate, be sure to let us know that information so we can celebrate with you. And then yoga in the Grove starts on Thursday, June 13th. Our May mission has been collecting cereal for the Northern Lehigh Food Bank, and we will continue to collect it through next week. We're over 200 boxes, but we're not quite at our goal of 300. So if you have some cereal to bring, please do that. And to be honest, we collect food all summer long, so you can continue to bring cereal. It's always a big item that's needed, as well as any other items for the food bank, and our volunteers will be sure to get that there for you. The Iron Pigs Night has been sold out, 80 tickets. Woo, it's a big crowd. But you're still welcome to buy your own tickets that day and come and find us and hang out with us. Vacation Bible School, the end of June. We're so excited to be able to host that again. So if you have kids, be sure to sign them up as soon as you can. And if you're still thinking about helping, be sure to let us know that. And if you have friends or family, it's really helpful to us if you help them know that, about Bible School, and invite them and encourage neighbors to come and to support our effort and to be part of the fun. You are the best source of inviting people to be a part of our church life here. You're the best person to invite people to visit and join our church. You're the best representation of God's church here at Union to encourage and support others as they look for a place to belong. So please do all that you can to share Facebook posts or emails or our newsletter and to share the good news of God's love here at Union. Because of you, our church changes lives. And so we pray over the offering. In our offering, we share not only measurable treasures of time, talents, and resources, we also radically commit to sharing immeasurable gifts, gifts of forgiveness, grace, compassion, acceptance, and loving concern with each and everyone, with each other and with ourselves. Amen. to build the community of care and compassion that we hope to create. May they be a legacy of justice, hope, faith, and most importantly, love. Amen. The one who created all that is calls us by name and invites us into a life of abundant love. We go into the world as God's beloved people, bringing holy love to all whom we meet. Jesus taught us to love one another as fiercely and freely as God loves each of us, with the power that binds us together as the body of Christ. We'll embody Christ by shattering stigma and welcoming all, leaving no one outside. The Spirit fills us with the breath of life and urges us to imagine anew how to be church in the world today. We will breathe deeply and move beyond what has been and what is. We will follow the Spirit and bring hope and healing to all who live in despair and brokenness. We will be the church. Amen.
Praise him, all creatures here below. Praise him above, ye heavenly host. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Unfailing love comes with the morning. It's your faith. Glory to our Maker and a thousand arms.